So next example in recursion is run length coding. So before going for the coding part, I will explain what is this run length coding. This is actually a data compression technique, very simple, okay, very fundamental data compression technique. So you may be wondering what is this data compression, but you may be using it frequently. Okay. You may be using this frequently. For example, I don't know the exact mail capacity. Say for example, you can send a maximum of 10 MB through email. Okay. But you have the file with more than, say for example, 12 MB, something like that. So what you will do, you will go for that zip or WinRAR kind of thing. Okay. So what it will do, actually it will compress the data so that you can send the data efficiently through the mail. Okay. This is one such technique. Data compression means you are representing the data. The data can be anything like image or audio, video. You are representing the data with less number of bits. Okay, if you want, I will write. Since you are communication engineers, these are very much useful when you study a course called Information Theory and Coding. So, representing, okay, information or data, representing information with less number of bits. This is actually called data compression. Run length coding is one such data compression technique. How it works? Let me write the procedure so that you can remember. So this is effective when repeated values, okay, when repeated values occur at adjacent positions. Okay, repeated values. Otherwise, this is not effective. You have to go for some other code. Say for example, you have a text data. Okay, you have your word file, there is some text, or you can assume you have a list. Okay, you have to operate on the list. Say for example, this is the list, and these are the list entries 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. As I said earlier, this is very much effective when you have repetitive patterns. Okay, say 8 times A is occurring, then say for example 6 times B is occurring. Okay, then again 4 times A, okay, say 1 times C. So this is the information available as the text. Okay, so how you can compress means, so just first you write what is the character, next you write how many times it is repeating. So 2, 4, 6, 8 times it is repeating, comma, next character B, you just see how many times it is repeating. So 3 plus 3, it's 6 times. Again A, okay, so 4 times it is repeating. C, only one time. So what I want to convey, don't send this one to the receiver, send this information to the receiver. At the receiver, if you get this information, you can replicate. So you know A is occurring 8 times. So you just replicate A 8 times. Then B is occurring 6 times. You just replicate B 6 times. Then A is occurring 4 times. You replicate A 4 times. Then C. So no need to transmit this data. This particular information, it contains, it occupies more number of bits. Whereas this will occupy less number of bits. So try to transmit this. So you are effectively utilizing. Okay, you are effectively utilizing the bandwidth. So this, in order to do this, I'm going to write a code. I'm going to implement this using, okay, recursion concept. This run length coding, I'm going to implement using recursion concept. So the function name, okay, I'm going to create a function, encode. This function, it can take, okay, it can take either a list or string as the input. Okay, either list or string as the input. Okay, the function should return a list, something like this. Okay, it should return a list. Otherwise, I can say a compressed list. Just for understanding, I'm telling compressed list. We need to write a function encode. That function should accept a list or string. Okay, either you can give a list something like this, or you can give string something like this. So, like this, you can give A, then B. You can give either list or string. So you need to compute something and you have to return a list something like this. Okay, this is one thing. Another point, you need to write another function, which is main function. So this main function, in the main function, you need to read the input string or list. Okay, read string or list from the user. So I'm going to use input method. Okay, and this main function should display the compressed list. Okay, it should display the compressed list. So what I'm doing, I'm just going for the code. Again, I'm coming for this whiteboard explanation. First, I'm going for the code. I'm developing the code. So most of you can understand in the code itself. If you are not understanding also, no issue. While I am explaining in the whiteboard, you can easily understand. Okay. Let me go for the spider. So this function is run length coding using recursion. Okay, run length coding using recursion. The function name is encode some data. This data can be a string or it can be a list. Okay, some meaningful input argument. Suppose the data can be a empty data. Okay, the list can be a empty list, or the string can be an empty list. If we need to accommodate this exceptional cases also. So when the list is empty or the string is empty, we need to return empty. No need to process, no need to compress, because nothing is there in the string, nothing is there in the list. So no need to compress. Okay, so first I'm just including that case. If length of data double equal to 0, okay, I am going to return a empty list. Then, okay, otherwise, if you want, you can use else, otherwise directly you can process. See, you know, I am going to use a while loop here. I will tell why you need a while loop. But for a while loop, you know, there should be an initialization, there should be some condition, there should be some update. Okay, so here the initialization is index equal to 1, then while loop, while index less than length of data. okay, while index less than length of data and data index is equal to data index minus 1. Okay, you know how to access a string, how to access a list item. So the list name in square bracket, the corresponding index will be using. Okay, same thing I am doing here. Same thing I am doing here. So use a colon here. Now what I will do, I will update index is equal to index plus 1. I didn't explain still. Current is equal to data of 0, comma index. Okay. So what I want to convey, there is a while loop. For the while loop, we need a initialization, we need some condition, and we need some update. That is there in the code. So after the while loop, I am just creating a list. Current, the list name is current, data of 0 is the first item, second one is whatever the final, once the while loop is over, you have some index, that index I am just adding in the list. Why list format? Means as per the question, the output should be in list format. That is the reason I have preferred list here. Okay, then this entire function, this entire encode function, it has to return this current, but still it is not over. So I am just going for a recursion. The function name is encode. Okay. Then the input for the encode is data index, data index colon length of data. Okay. Length of data. So I will explain the programming part now. Let me copy this part. Okay, so this is what I have typed in the spider. Okay. So for example, I'm just taking a data. Okay. I'm just giving input something like 4 times A, 3 times B, 1 C. This is the input string I'm giving. Okay, so that is assigned to data. So listen carefully. So here I am explaining. Okay, so we know the index starts from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So can anyone say what is the length of this data? What is the length of the data?
8.
Very good. 8. So what about this condition? If 8 double equal to 0, then only we have to return a empty list. It's not equal to 0. Okay. So it comes for index. So first index is equal to 1. It is initialized to 1. Okay. Index is initialized to 1. Next. So in the while loop, 1 less than, okay, length of data is 8. This is true, but I'm just using logical AND so that when both are true, then only it will enter into the while loop. Okay. And data of, what is the index I have initialized? 1. So data of 1. Here I made a mistake. Okay. Here this should be double equal to. I'm just checking. It's not assignment. Here it should be double equal to. I will correct while I'm typing. So data double equal to data of index minus 1. 1 minus 1, it is 0. Okay. So when both are true, then only I will go within the while loop. You just see data of one is A, data of 0 is A, both are same. So this is true. 1 is less than 8. This is also true. So what I'm doing, I'm just updating the index. So the index becomes 2. We know about while loop. Until the condition satisfied, the loop will go. Okay. Next time, I'm just checking whether 2 less than 8 and data of, now the index of data is 2, double equal to data of index minus 1, which is 1. I'm just checking data of 2 is A, data of 1 is A. So what happens, this is also true, this is also true. So it enters into the while loop and the index is incremented to 3. Now 3 less than 8 and data of 3 double equal to data of 2. So data of 3 is, okay, data of 3 is A, data of 2 is A. So both are A. So this is also true, this is also true. So index becomes 4. Okay. Now 4 less than 8. Logical and data of 4 double equal to data of 3. Okay. So data of 4 double equal to data of 3. So 4 is B, data of 3 is A. So this is B, this is A, both are not equal. So this is true, this is false. So overall it is false. So it comes out of the while loop. It comes out of the while loop. Now you are just creating a dictionary. Current is equal, I'm sorry, it's not dictionary. You are creating a list. Okay, current. Data of 0 is A, comma index. What is the recent index?
4.
So what happens? You have a list where you have the first character A followed by the index 4. Okay. Then what you are doing after this current, you are returning current plus encode. Okay, return this particular list plus you are calling the function again encode, but what is the input for the encode? You just see data, I'm just starting from the index. Okay, now the index is actually 4, the last index is 4. So data of 4 colon, okay, length of data is 8. So we know this, in order to concatenate, we don't know this. So we have to again execute, we have to call this function with the new input. Can anyone say what is 4 colon 8? This is the start index, it is inclusive. This is stop index, it is exclusive. So the new data is 4th index is B, 5th index is B, 6th index B, 7th index C, 8th index is exclusive. So B, 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 C. Okay. So the new indices 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Again, you have to check. The very first condition is, you have to check whether the length of data is equal to 0. Here, the length of the data is 4. It's not 0. Length of the data is 4. Okay. So, I'm just going for else part. Again, you have initialized index is equal to 1. You are just checking whether index less than length of data and data of index double equal to data of index minus 1. So 1 minus 1, it is 0. So you are just checking whether data of 1, which is B, data of 0, it's also B. So this condition is also true. This condition is also true. So the index is incremented to 2. Again, while loop is running, I'm just checking whether 2 less than 4. Yes. And data of 2 double equal to data of 1. So data of 2 is, data of 2 is B, data of 1 is B. So both are correct. So index becomes 3. Now 3 less than 4, true. And data of 3 double equal to data of 2. Just check this. So data of 3 is C, data of 2 is B. Both are not equal. One condition fails also, it is failed. So it comes out of the loop. So now this new dictionary is, I'm using dictionary. List, okay, new list is created, current, data of 0, comma index, okay, current, so data of 0, now data of 0 is B, data of 0 is B, okay, the last index is 3, okay, now we are returning, this list plus, again you are calling the encode, okay, within the encode data of index is to length of data, index is 3, now length of data is 4. So, can anyone say how many values will be there in the data?
So, 2.
2 or 1?
1.
What is that value?
C.
Okay. Now, what is the length of data? One. So I'm just checking again. Okay. Length of data is not equal to zero. It goes for initializing index. Index is equal to one. We are just checking whether index one less than one. Okay. Here itself it fails. It's not less than one. One less than one. It's not correct. So what happens? It comes out of the while loop, it is not at all entering to the while loop. So current is, a new list, current, that is equal to data of 0. Data of 0 is C. Data of 0 is C, and index is just 1. So now I am returning, I'm just returning this list plus encode data of index is 1 colon length of data, that is also 1. So what is the nature of this data now? Start index and stop index, they are same. So is it a empty list?
Yes, sir.
Okay. When you pass a empty list to encode, what it will return?
Empty list.
Very good. Empty list. So this particular function, it returns empty list. So this plus empty list, you know how to add list. Okay. How to join two list using plus operator. So if you join these two, you will get the same. Okay. For example, here I will show, I have a list C1, okay, plus empty list. You just see, you will get the same list. Okay, you will get the same list. Then this entire thing actually returns C, 1. So here you will have C, 1. So that is actually joined with this list. Okay, that is joined with this list. So the previous list is B, 3 plus C, 1. You have this list. Then if you see here, this encode, it has B4C B3 times C1, that is actually added with A4. So what happens? A4 plus B3 C1. So this is what we wanted, right? If you enter something like A4 times B3 times C1 time, you want the, you need to get output something like this. So let me correct the code here. What I will do, I will just add a main function. Okay, I will add a main function. Yeah, I have to define this. Define main. Here actually I'm just getting the string. Okay, so S is equal to input, enter a string. Okay, enter some characters. If you want, you can also use list. So print run length coded output is. Okay, so what I'm doing, I'm just printing encode in bracket s. So I'm just getting the string from the user. This is some print statement before the output. So this s is passed to the function. So the function has to return this type of output. Okay, let me try. So now I'm just calling the main function. So within the main function, I'm giving the input. Okay, so 4 times A, 3 times B, 1 times C. You just see, I am getting output similar to this. Okay, how many times A is repeating that character, then the repetition count, next character, repetition count, next character, repetition count. Okay, so let me try with some other input, main. Okay, capital A, capital C, capital Z, B, something like this. So if you notice, A 11 times, then C 6 times, Z 4 times, B 1 times, D 5 times, then A 1 time. Okay, so the code is working perfectly. So this is another example for recursion. This encode function calls the encode function itself.